Looking at the UTS, we were checking what type of projects, of course, are of interest to show. Of course, we can show how good we are with A, B, and C. But in Venice, a very nice place, and a lot of people like to go to, have a serious problem already for many years. They are flooded now and then. And if you have been in Venice, and I'm the one of the lucky guys, have been there quite often, and you come there and it is flooded, then you find it a nightmare. I think the people in the UK last year found out how it is, getting out of your house and getting into extension of the river. And in Venice, there is a project called MOS. They're called Moses at the moment. Well, you know why, but it's called MOS. And that is a project we work on for many years already. It's going on for 10 years and it will go on for another 2 years. MOS is the project to protect Venice from flooding. How are they going to do that, or what are they doing? Here you have the Venice city and the island Lido, etc. And here you have, say, the entrances. The idea is to close, say, the entrances to the city of or to the lagoon of Venice when high water is coming in or forced by the wind. A lot of tourists are visiting Venice yearly. I had no idea. I thought a few thousand. It's 20 million people visiting Venice per year. A lot of them comes by the cruise vessels. So if you are in Venice, you see a lot of cruise vessels coming in and out. So of course you cannot make a search barrier when blocking, say, the vessels coming in and out. You can imagine with that amount of tourists, it goes in and out almost continuously. What it is, I found a very nice animation on it of it was, and I think that explains quite something of how they approach it and how it will be built.
The mobile devices are made up of a row of gates, which is set in a trench in the bed of the inlet that reaches from one end of the inlet to the other. The row is made up of metal gates, with one side attached to their base by means of two hinges. Special things apply to this exterior, which protects them from the aggression of the marine environment. Rotating around the axis of the hinges, rise until they emerge and isolate the lagoon from the sea. When the high water ebbs, the water in the lagoon and the sea reaches the same level, the gates are filled once again with water until they return to their original position. The fixed structures of the inlet, such as the outer breakwaters and the raising of the pavement and the lagoon banks of the inhabited areas of the lagoon, contribute to the reduction of the number of the most frequent floods. This optimizes the management of the mobile barriers and limits their use to 3 to 5 times a year, given the current level of the sea. The entire system of defense will be extremely efficient, functional, and flexible. Opening the gates, which we see here, is carried out according to precise procedures, with which the possible increase in the water level of the lagoon, resulting from the flow of the rivers, from rain, from local increases due to the wind, and water passing between one gate and another, is also taken into account. Altogether, there are 4 rows of gates. One at the inlet of Mount Morco with 19 gates, increase in the sea level during the next 100 years.
So, yeah, I think now you have a good impression of what it will be and almost is. And I'd like to show from, say, when we started a little bit about the history. The project you can find these days more on the internet. The last couple of years it was difficult to find, so some lectures you could find. But it's a very big project. It's 50 different companies are involved. The total value will be well estimated at 5 billion euro at the moment. Probably the budget was lower, as normal on this type of project. We are involved from almost the beginning, 2004. We started and we delivered in the different times, different systems. So you started with, say, the multi-beam systems for hydrographic surveys, single beam echo sounders, and the software for the guidance of the dredge applications and charting, etc. One of the challenges is, of course, that the lagoon of Venice is a moor, so very soft sediment. And placing these concrete caissons where the doors will be in is, of course, not possible on a very soft sediment. So it was decided that a vibration installation had to be installed and dense the sediment. Then, of course, the customer had a question. They have to monitor that, did they reach the certain density at that location, and where did we do it? So they had really two issues. So, of course, in Italy, a lot of communication goes through an agent, and in this case, Codefintech. And to be honest, we did not really visit often the site, or rarely, to be honest. It's fully supported from the local agent. So in this case, for the placing of the caissons, the last part which we discuss here, or want to show you, is that, well, they have an idea, of course, because, well, they are a construction company, but they need the tools to do so. Also for the vibration, it was about the same. So they had a meeting and we explained them by link meeting or conference call what we can do. So in this case, we adjusted the software PDS so that with the position and where the reflectivity could be updated in the DTM. So that was accepted as the right QC tool. Of course, dredging of the trench, as you will see, is done by hydraulic excavators and by wire cranes. For that we supplied a number of installations to various customers. What you see is, of course, this is not necessarily Venice, of course, but as an indication. So in the software you have the DTM from, in this case, the Seabed 8125. You put in the design and the dredge according to the design, according to the specifications. So in this case, you make a nice trench. More for this application you can see during the workshops. So we have a real one out later. During different phases we had, as you may saw, we have three locks or three sections to do with different water depths. The last section is the deep water part, 25 meter depth. This section is ready already. This is finalized, one of the first ones. And they use this, portable, or crane construction for caisson placement. And what they did is they put towers on it, as you can see here. So you sail the towers using real-time kinematic. And on the last part with self-tracking laser systems to reach, say, the millimeter accuracy. The accuracy to be met was 12 millimeter for positioning X, Y, Z. Placing the doors is, of course, another issue or a difficult item on the lagoon. So here you can see a construction, how they place the door. Or in this case, we use the, say, wire crane construction as we have. So you get a crane and you get the XYZ, but here they took in an arm And on the arm is, say, you can imagine as a second vessel, so that arm is fitted with positioning system on both ends. So you have XYZ, XYZ on each end, also the heading, plus you have motion sensors on it. So in here you can just guide the door very carefully to the final position. Also that was done using the PDS software. An impression of the different barges over there, they are huge. I mean, a caisson is about 35 meter by 25 meter, so that is quite something. As I mentioned, the project started in 2004. It will go on for another 2 years, I understood, to finalize it. They're coming now to the last part. The water depth is there 25 meters, so they have other difficulties then to get the accuracy of the 12.5 millimeter. Here you can see the base. I have more images later on where the caissons are built and then moved from, say, this location to the final location where they have to be sinking. These caissons was are done by another party, so another company. And again, they contacted us, and they of course worked out a complete way they saw and envisioned how to install them. So they place a number of motion sensors inside the caisson, so you have a full backup. They put towers on it for, say, the positioning system, and RTK, XYZ. But of course, they need to be guided on location quite accurate. And that means that one caisson has to place next to the other one. So you can use one caisson, which is placed already, as a reference for the other one. That is the best way to do. But of course, then you have to know exactly where the previous one was placed. So we made an example project for this customer. As PDS is, you can imagine, as a big, large toolbox with different views and possibilities, it is not difficult to tune to an application like that. So we just listen to the customer, and in this case, we have, for example, this view we made, where you can set, for example, different points. How it works is, this is, for example, the caisson already placed, and each caisson has a number of offset points. So we'll see offset point 1, 2, 3, 4. So each corner of the caisson will have an offset point known in the software. At a certain moment, you have placed the caisson, and then you just press here you are, and it will change color, in this case purple. That means this is fixed. Directly, here will be the reference for the next one to be placed automatically. And you will get the guidance to the next pontoon. This is a small example from an animation I had from them, so a replay of data. So what you can see here, for example, you have all the points, all the nodes, 1, 2, 3, 4, and they're connected directly, automatically to the caisson to be placed. You have a lot of numerical values you can put in, the distances, the angle. You can, for example, place a center line as a route, and then the center of the caisson will be aligned for heading on that route. And each node, as I say, you can be have displayed over here. Of course, you have more displays. This is the 3D. You have more screens, so they have 2D views, etc., etc. This is just for now to show how it works. So you see all those nodes connected, so they know where they go to, and they move this caisson careful in their position. It's a long file, so it takes quite some time to put it in position. But as you can see here, you have different views to make. This is the view I would select. They have other views they want to see. So it's just user, settable, and you save the layout as you like to see. Here is an example of the real-time images as they have seen on the location. Here they use the solid 3D shapes to fit it in, and one is coming in here. Of course, 3D is nice, but often they use the 2D to look at. So here you have the plan view in the 2D with all the horizontal and vertical bars telling you. You give it a name, so this is an offset point. So you give each view the name of the offset point, so you know what you talk about and what you look at. Some impressions of the of local of the constructions and the vessels in the field. You see the towers. I mean, water depth is 25 meters, so well, quite high towers, of course. The yard. Of course, when you have trench, the trench is made. You have the plates to support the trench, and gravel was placed below the caissons and the PDSA diking module for the crane, as you can see here, is then used to lay the gravel at a certain thickness on the right location. So you just take a crab, you tell the software the volume of the crab, and then we position accurate and update with a sort of a spreading factor, which is known by the customer. They know what is the spreading factor, and then that is the way you place the gravel in the trench. The first exercises here, when the first doors were in position, so they have done a number of trials. You can see that was last year, October, one of the first times they started to practice if the whole concept is working. When I saw this animation first time, I said, well, it's quite simple, because I knew we had to place doors, but I did not know until I saw the movie how they did it, putting pressed air in it. That's why I showed the movie to start with, quite well, new and really nice to see. Support. Well, as I mentioned, you need, of course, support, in this case, local. I mean, our agent is situated in Milan, so that is not that far away from Venice. And a lot of support is done by TeamViewer. But, yeah, we went on location to install this and train, say, one day. Then we leave, and then, say, the agent and the engineers, they're taking over, and the customer. So that means it's pretty straightforward to operate and to set up. It's of course a lot of setup and project preparation, and that you import in the software. And yeah, I mean, I thought I select this project. It was it's a quite difficult project, and of course with a lot of different companies involved, and a lot of Italians involved. And sorry, Andrea, but it's not always easy. And they have a lot of demands and wishes, but they are not always known. And a lot of, well, expected that, but to be honest, it went all smoothly and okay, and so far so good. So today, over 80% of the project is finished. Gravel is put in place while I was making this presentation, so that is the status at the moment. And yeah, I mean, what we did for the project together with our agent is monitoring the dredge survey, monitoring of the placement and reporting and support the project as good as possible. And as I noticed, this is, yeah, we have to do this because otherwise Venice is not there in a couple of years. I mean, they lower, I think it's about a centimeter per annum. And well, if you have 20 million tourists walking around on Venice, that is not helping to get it stopped by sinking into the sediment. But yeah, this was the presentation about Venice. I hope you find it of interest. It is nearby, but well, you will see it on the television probably when the first doors will be closed and open and when the project is finalized. Thank you very much.